I am Jamunil Kilsedar. I will present the work that I did with NASA in 2017 in Google Summer of Code. So why OSM data visualization is a challenging problem that need our attention. OSM data, first of all, can be said that has big data characteristics. For instance, it has velocity, variety, and volume features that are usually attributed with big data. And you can see how, since OSM data is updated all the time, the veracity of it is in question, and it has high volume, especially when it comes to visualization. So to address this challenge, I developed application programming interface, or API, with for NASA Webwork Wind virtual globe during Google Summer of Code in 2017. This virtual globe is an API for geospatial data visualization in general, so it supports many kinds of formats. And it is developed in partnership with European Space Agency. And it is built using JavaScript and WebGL, which means that it runs in browsers. And I focused in this project on buildings, because buildings are quite easy to visualize in three dimensions. And the rest of the data is visualized in 2D. The source code of this plugin is open source, and you can find it on my GitHub repository. And also, using this API, I developed an application, and also attended the NASA Europa Challenge in 2017. You can use these URLs to check the application. So why did I do this? I want to go over existing tools that are visualizing OSM data in three dimensions on web, and shortly talk about their shortcomings, so to justify why I did this. As you know, Mapbox has a good support for 3D building visualization, and it has good performance because it supports vector tiling. However, you need to pay after 50,000 map views per month. OSM buildings is also a very reliable and good tool. However, it is also paid after 50,000 views per month. F4Map is not an open source solution for this kind of application. Open Science Map is not an API, so you cannot immediately start using it in your own application. OSM Go is not an API or on GitHub. Mapzen has shut down in January 2018, and OSM 3D is currently not supported anymore. And there are a couple of other APIs or solutions, let's say, that exist that you can check on this wiki page. What does the API that I developed during this Google Summer of Code period, 3 months period? First of all, I can say that it is free and open source fully, and it is capable of visualizing OSM data both in 2D and 3D. And it fetches the OSM data in real time based on a bounding box. You can use a file of your own, or you can use the GeoJSON file, GeoJSON data itself in your JavaScript code. You can immediately use the OSM database to assign the height to the buildings, or you can generate the height to the buildings and then create a new attribute in your GeoJSON file and use that value for to assign height to the buildings, or you can give the same value for all the buildings. In my case, I use the height tag available in OSM database to set the heights. Other than that, if it is not available, there are also building levels tag that can be used to approximate the height of the buildings. And if neither are available, I simply assume that the building is 5-level high. And also the API can create a heat map based on the heights of the buildings. And I also attempted to implement caching and tiling for this visualization to improve the performance. However, it is not fully implemented. So especially in the case of 3D visualization, it might have some performance issues. And then here you can see a video of the application and see how it works. As you can see, it's a virtual globe, so you have all the support for 3D geodata visualization. It's an open source API, NASA web plugin. Here you can go to the place that you want to visualize the data for, set the color, set the OSM tag, set the bounding box, and get the data for the region that you are interested in. The first one was the farmlands, so polygons. And this one is for highways in Como, so line features in OSM. And finally, also you can, on top of the virtual globe, put the point information. In this case, I chose restaurants in Istanbul. This is the 2D visualization, and the second case that I mentioned is a 3D visualization for buildings. Again, you can set the color you want, you choose if you want to extrude the data or not, and load your file. Then, as you can see, it is fully 3D. It is not 2.5D, it is fully 3D. And apart from using the file, you could also just, as in the 2D case, draw the bounding box on the globe and fetch the data. This is another example from New York. New York has a very rich database in terms of the OSM height for buildings. In the other parts of the world, the heights are not that rich. However, you can see that it is the height tag exists in New York for almost each building. So it gives a very realistic visualization. So apart from these, what did I do? I also tried to create triangle meshes using the footprint and the height information to improve the rendering and painting performance instead of just extruding the buildings, which proved to improve the performance. And to try to create the triangle meshes, I used the ear cut algorithm that is openly available from Mapbox. I also, because in Milan the building heights are very rare, I also use the LiDAR data for Milan that we have, and GrassGIS to extract the building heights, store the results in the GeoJSON, and visualize the data that is extracted from the LiDAR data to have a realistic visualization of Milan, because otherwise, as I said, the data for Milan is very scarce for the heights, contrary to New York, for instance. How did I do this? I extracted the DTM from DSM, and the DTM is the last returns of the LiDAR data, and DSM is the first returns. This gives the height for each point on the map, and then for all the points that exist in the building footprint, I calculated the median and then just assigned a new attribute in the data in the GeoJSON file and used this for the visualization. I did something similar also for Rome, and in this case I used the Urban Atlas building height 2012 data from the Copernicus program. This building height raster data is available also for other cities. And so what is the what is the advantage of using this this API? First of all, you can easily fetch the data that you're interested in using the bounding box, for instance. Or if you already prepared your data, you can immediately use that in GeoJSON format. And you can create the, you can choose any color you want. And then also, if you are visualizing data in 3D, you can create heat maps, which in a way enables visual analysis. For instance, you can see in the city where are the buildings that are like higher than the others, because you can immediately see that through the colors. And also, in my experience, I go over the cities because I already have the satellite imagery underneath. When I get, for instance, the buildings in that region or any kind of data, I immediately see if that city has the data in OSM for the buildings, because in satellite imagery I see that there are buildings, but they are not fetched from the OSM databases. Allows me to immediately see where the data is missing in OSM. And what could be done more? In the OSM database, there are other tags available that can be used to more realistically visualize the OSM buildings. For instance, there is minimum height, building minimum level tags, the roof tags to create the roofs of the buildings. And also there are tags related to surface color and material of the buildings, which could be used to improve the visualization of the buildings. If the vector tiling is implemented fully, then the OSM data for larger regions could also be visualized. And on top of that, if frustum culling is implemented, then the performance of the visualization would improve even further. I want to emphasize that this API, the fact that it is developed for a virtual globe and an open source virtual globe, not a web or wind, enables you to use all kinds of geospatial data. For instance, you can use WMS, WFS, and raster data, and then also bring the power of OSM in your application. And this is it. Thank you very much for listening.
Thank you very much. We're a few minutes ahead of schedule, so that means a few extra minutes for questions.
Yeah, very interesting project. I've dealt with 3D OSM since, I don't know, 10 years or something for different apps and stuff. The problem there was, by end of the day, the practical usability of that. We couldn't find any real use cases to kind of pay off the investments to all these nice visualizations. Have you found any kind of secrets there?
You mean how this visualization is going to be useful?
Yeah.
Well, I believe that having the city visualization in a more realistic way allows us to see how the city is really structured, and I think this is a benefit. And in the case of building this API for the virtual globe, actually the investment is not as high as expected.
Thank you. Maybe I can help to answer the question.
Yeah.
I am urban planning. So I think it's very useful for us that work in with architecture or urban planning, because to regulate height of buildings in some areas of the city, this can help us to create strategies for heritage plans. Also, maybe what else? see how high can we build in some parts of the city, if there is an airport, if there is an important icon in the city, etc. Like things like this is very important, it's very useful. Thank you.
Thank you. Does this work in like a hilly relief area? If you, do you have the data terrain model plus the height of the building, for example?
Because the virtual globe itself has the terrain information already. So the data is put on top of the terrain. And since we extract the DSM from the DTM, then we get the real height of the building put on top of the terrain that is provided by the NASA. So there is no problem that you mentioned in this case. Because it is not simply a sphere, it is a realistic representation of the Earth.
More questions or comments? Final chance. Okay, so we put our hands together for a very nice presentation.